trespassing on private property. Please leave the facility. You have 20 seconds to comply.
Holy tomato! What are you?
You now have 15 seconds to comply.
Wait a minute. Hold on. I'm not here to talk show. I'm just here for a visit. That's all. Just let me in.
You now have 5 seconds to comply.
No. Wait,
four,
no, stop. No.
Three.
Would you just hear me out? I'm just.
One. I am now authorized to use deadly force.
Oh, crud.
Why he's shooting at you!
I did!
Oh, really? Because last I checked, I didn't get a notification. Oh, hang on. Huh. Well, you know. You did. Perception here is crap, let me tell you. It's okay, Rob. He's meant to be here.
Okay.
Alright, that situation's taken care of. But where did you afford that thing?
First off, one, I didn't afford him, I hired him. Secondly, don't you ever call him a thing. He's just as sentient as you and me. And thirdly, he's my bodyguard!
Okay, I'm sorry, I mean... Jeez, I didn't know. I mean, why are you so angry all the time? I mean, seriously.
Yeah, that's another thing, Dean. First off, that's my line. And secondly, if you're an internet reviewer and a mechanist like I am, I think you understand things the way I do. Now tell me what's your business here.
Oh, right. Well, I just heard you were reviewing the Sonic fan film by Blue Core Studios.
I am?
So I was thinking, why do I review it with you? You know, like a co-review kind of thing.
So, can I do it with you?
Well, I don't see why not. We've already dragged this on long enough.
Awesome! Let's do this!
Sonic the Hedgehog!
Released on June 23rd, 1991 for the Sega Genesis by the company of the same name during their competition with Nintendo, Sonic the Hedgehog gave Sega its footing in creating a legacy similar to other game legends like Mario, Link, Samus, Master Chief, Crash Bandicoot, Mega Man, and a number of others, as well as spawning countless sequels and spin-offs and some reboots, even long after Sega left the console wars and a feature-length movie which did surprisingly well, but to be fair, that might have been due to the internet. Aside from that, however, like many big-name franchises, there's always a fan base. And where there's a fan base, there's fan fiction. And where there's fan fiction, there's most likely, without a doubt, fan films.
You forgot to mention before the actual movie, the Sonic game spawned cartoon shows, several anime, comics, and Sonic himself joining Smash Brothers.
And you seem to have forgotten he also joined Mario in the Olympics. On several occasions, so there.
I know that. Boy, you seem to know a lot about Sonic. So are you,
No!
Rambling and squabbling aside, years before the actual movie was released, a company by the name of Blue Court Studios decided it would be a good idea to make a movie based on the infamous Blue Blur.
Since it came out, just like Combiner Wars, it was not well received by fans and mostly newcomers.
And you're about to find out why as we dig into the Sonic fan film.
Hey, wait, where'd that beer come from? It wasn't there when I just barged into your room.
Dean, the moment I found out Sith Lords, Faunus, and various alien creatures existed on this planet, I stopped asking questions.
Well, anyway, roll the footage.
Hey, don't try to steal lines from the hardcore.
So the movie opens up with the ring. Okay. Then it shoots out the Chaos Emeralds, and wait a minute! Julia White is voicing Sonic in this?
This would have been badass if the movie wasn't shit. So we then cut to a forest on a planet, Mobius.
Of course, why not? By the way, that reminds me, let's play a little game. Where is he a famous internet celebrity in this fan film? Take a drink.
Hey, wait, I don't do drugs, you idiot!
Unfortunately for you, pretty boy, I do.
So we then see Mobius being invaded by Dr. Eggman's forces.
They are the Punisher Elite, born to compete, never retreat.
Ghost Invasion,
living or dead, always ahead, fed by your dread.
Already, I instantly regret my decision.
That missile just...
No.
So Eggman's armada invades the city and...
Oh my god! Brento Floss! Oh!
He won't be the last one, sadly.
Oh, shut up!
Also, you gotta love how the people in the city are acting like a massive military force and Bang is just like birdwatching to these bozos.
And why are there actual humans living on Mobius than rather Earth?
Mobius.
Dean, I don't fucking know and don't fucking care. So the president of Mobius and other news reporters are talking about what's going on.
Oh, come on, it's not like if any of the reporters is played by James Rowe. Are you serious?
Told you. Oh, and by the way, his name isn't Eggman or Robotnik, it's Kentober. Kentober. Real original movie!
Wait, is James Rowe playing Eggman?
No, James Rowe was playing a reporter. Eggman, or Kentober, is played by someone who I have no fucking idea who he is.
Hang on, let me look it up. Huh, DJ Hazard. Heard of him?
Not really, let's move on.
Okay.
And so he reverses his name to Robotnik.
He is no more. I am now...
Why am I not surprised in the slightest?
I represent the perfection this society needs. I envision a society under a sole leader. My society. My leadership.
Your society and leadership? I'm sorry, am I missing something?
He's trying to take over the world.
Of course!
Oh, you know, that gag never gets old.
Yup.
So we then meet our titular hero, Sonic, as he narrates what happened all the while running around, and here we see another problem. Jaleel White's performance is fucking atrocious!
What do you mean atrocious? He sounds okay to me. Did you forget he voiced Sonic in the cartoons, you dummy?
I don't give a shit!
Bitch, watch me!
You would have thought that, with experience, they'd improve upon the performance on their character. Such as Peter Cullen with Optimus Prime, Mark Hamill with Luke Skywalker, Brad Swale with Amuro Ray, and the rest of the cast of the original Inuyasha, minus the original voice actress for Kagome, of course. Jaleel, on the other hand, is a glaring exception. You sound like he's portraying his role for the first time despite doing it for years. If you can't do in the performance that you're known for, it's not a good look. Criticism aside, we then see one of the captured soldiers played by Doug Walker. And now with that being said, here are a few Doug Walker jokes.
Chance, have you seen the blue blur? Answer the question or face the consequences.
Are you gonna make me review Babe? Well, I'm sorry you feel that way, but I don't know where he is. Wait, are you gonna show me a bad credit card? No, not demo reel. Anything but demo reel. Okay, I'm done. So before they have the chance to finish him off, Sonic comes in to save the day, and here we see another problem with this movie.
Way past cool, huh?
You have just witnessed, with your own eyes, one of the worst CGI models in film history. And I don't just mean in fan film history. It's quite pitiful and upsetting when the original model for the Sonic the Hedgehog movie looks better than this shite.
So Sonic leaves the soldier behind and heads to... Wait, we're cutting back to the city? I thought this fan film was about Sonic!
So he then cut to a newscast, which is cut off by the Robotnik Empire. So, they took over, somehow.
We cut to a torture chamber where a guy is being interrogated by a... I'm sorry, Robotnik to talk about Sonic.
So, you've seen it?
I don't know what it is. I barely got a good look.
You were there! You saw plenty. Tell me what it is.
Is the Zack Snyder cut of Justice League any good, goddammit?
God, this movie's so fucking terrible! It makes me want to play Wing Commander 3! I don't even have anything to play it on!
Well, and I want to play Sonic Mania, and I have it for the Switch. So there!
Oh, shut up!
We got to more soldiers that are about to take down one of Eggman...
Robotnik, Dean.
Robotnik's ships.
Buzz Bombers! They know we're here.
Freeze, and I hate my life.
You hate everything, Tenobolts.
Oh, fuck off, Tin Can.
Sonic hears all the ruckus again, and he might help the soldiers. Again.
Jesus, look at those stupid robo-bees!
Yeah, they look like cheap action figures.
Sonic finally shows up and saves the day!
Ow. Ow. Ow.
Haha, impressed? I know. I can make quite an entrance. You know, I can come back and do that again.
An Islander?
The blur.
We're gonna make a fortune with this place.
Okay, now this is just getting awkward.
I mean, you're pretty and all, but...
Isn't Sonic supposed to be like 15 for Christ's sake?
You're
a hedgehog.
And we'll probably never see each other again after this fight. Bye!
Sonic lures away the robo-bees.
Bees, my god.
And it gets Robotnik's attention.
Fly, fly as fast as you can! You can't catch me! I'm Sonic the Hedgehog!
And so after a lengthy and boring-ass fight, Robotnik gets pissed and decides to fire a missile at Sonic, where he then pulls a Sega Sanshiro.
Oh! What the hell is that for?!
Do not bring up a Sega Legend when we're reviewing this schlock!
Sorry.
And for odd reasons, Sonic somehow brings the missile back to the ship to... Okay! Didn't Robotnik even try to make sure that missile was
Well, suck it up, Dean. We're almost done, so let's get this shit over with.
So Robotnik has placed a bounty on Sonic's head, and he managed to get a Chaos Emerald by courtesy of his minions. Still don't know how, given the movie never explains.
So our movie ends with Sonic heading to the Green Hill Zone and runs to it. Then we get a special cameo at the end.
If only you knew what we were all in for.
And that was Sonic the Hedgehog, the fan film by Blue Core Studios. Time for our pros and cons.
But barely any pros.
Exactly.
I mean, where do I begin on God's green earth? The CGI is terrible for one thing, the acting is atrocious, the character's forgettable, and the story is nothing more but poorly written tripe that's as if it's written by a goddamn 10-year-old trying to be edgy.
Yeah, and another thing, I think this movie was inspired by Sonic 06.
With a side of Sonic Sad AM. Whereas that I claim, this didn't.
And another thing, Indy, I find this movie to be really boring. Ungodly boring.
So, care to do this with me?
Oh, hell yes.
Final analysis is an F minus.
And another thing, I actually wanted to like this movie, but it did not do for me. So guys, avoid this movie. It's not worth your time.
If I can suggest an actual Cinemax Sonic experience, then see the movie released. It has heart, respect to the lore, entertainment value, and much more appeal than what we just witnessed.
Yes! It's over! It's finally over!
Indeed it is. So, that one.
I do have a question about Rob.
What about?
Well, did you hire him during your conflict with some crazy fanboys in your Vader review?
Actually, after, and especially after my fight with Silverwolf in Season 1, I think it does no harm to be prepared.
Okay, I guess it makes the...
What the hell?
What the? Hey, the door will open! Indy, what's the big idea?
Hey, don't look at me! The door isn't supposed to have a lock!
Huh? Oh!
Neither side is innocent.
You're still a traitor, you worthless piece.
We were children. Asked to fight an intergalactic war against an enemy we'd never met. Let's stop pretending our sides.
Sonic fan film.
Hey, wait, where'd that beard come from? It wasn't there when I just barged into your room like a couple minutes ago.
Dean, the moment I found out Sith Lords, Faunus, and other alien creatures existed on planet Earth, I stopped asking questions.
Okay, well, anyway, roll the footage.
Hey, don't try to steal lines from the hardcore kid.
Okay, cut. Right.
Of course, why not? Anyway, whenever you find an Of course, why not? Anyway, let's play a little game. Whenever you say... Of course, why not? You know what, anyway, let's play a game. Whenever you say a famous internet God, this movie is so fucking terrible, it makes me want to play Wing Commander 3! And I don't even have anything to play it on!
And I have Sonic Mania, and I have it for my Switch, so there!
Oh, shut up! Why do you care anyway? This movie fucking sucks and you know it!
Whatever.
Yeah, okay, genius. Did you actually send an appointment? Alright, let's write it.
Alright. Line. Did you at least tell me you were coming?
Alright, okay. So after a lengthy and boring-ass fight, Robotnik gets picked. So after a lengthy and boring-ass fight, Robotnik gets pissed and decides to fire a missile at Sonic. Then Sonic pulls Sega Sentro. Oh! What the hell is that for?
Do not bring up a Sega Legend when we're reviewing this schlock!
Okay. Sorry. Okay, that was perfect.
Do you want... Oh, yes! It's over! It's finally over!
Indeed it is. So... Now what?
Well, I do have a question about Rob.
What about him?
Well, did you hire him during some conflict with some crazy fanboys in your Vader review?
Actually, after, and especially since my fight with Silverwolf during Season 1, I think it does no harm to be prepared.
Okay, I guess it makes it...
What the hell? Okay, cut.
So you want to do it again?
And you're about to find out why as we dig into the Sonic fan film.
Hey, wait, where'd that beard come from? It wasn't there when I just barged into your room like a couple of minutes ago.
For the record, the moment I found out Sith Lords, Faunus, and various alien creatures existed on planet Earth, I stopped asking questions.
Okay, anyway, roll the footage!
Well, hey, you don't steal hardcore kids! He's my bodyguard, so kindly check your bigotry at the joke. God damn it, I was so close. Alright. Okay, first off, one, I didn't afford him, I hired him. Secondly, don't you ever call him a thing. He's just as sentient as you and I. And thirdly, referring to number two, he's my bodyguard, so kindly check your Fuck.
Keep trying, Brock, keep trying.
Alright. Okay.
This is going to prove for us, isn't it?
Yep. Okay, first off, one, I didn't have... BAM! Alright. Okay. First of all, one, I didn't afford him, I hired him. Secondly, do not ever refer to him as a thing ever again. And thirdly, as a means to play on number two, he's my bodyguard, so kindly check your bigotry at the door and show some respect, goddammit!
You got it. Okay. Okay, sorry, I didn't know. Jeez, why are you so angry all the time? I mean, seriously. No time for dumb questions.
The questions? You can't! You barged into my own room! No, I cut. That's right again.
Okay.
Line?
Dumb questions, you barge into my room and you're seriously telling me no dumb questions? Now you tell me how the hell you got in here or I get Rob up on your ass.
Alright. Dumb questions, you barge into my own room! Wait, let's try again. Dumb questions, you barge into my own home! Now tell me how the hell you got in here or I get Rob on your... Oh, damn it. Cut. Oh, suck it up, Dean. We're almost done with this shit, so let's get it over with.
Alright. That situation is taken care of.
Alright, cut. Sorry, I kind of... Action! Cut. My God, this movie's so fucking terrible! It makes me want to play Wing Commander 3! I don't even have anything to play it on!
And I have Sonic Mania for my Switch, and I have it, so there.
Oh, shut up. Alright, that was good.
And I just...
Alright, just let me know.
No time for dumb questions. You forgot to mention that before the actual movie, the Sonic game spawned a cart. I'm sorry, let me... Also, that noise...
Okay, stop.
Fly as fast as you can! You can't catch me! I'm Sonic!
God damn it!
Oh, I'm such an asshole with that line! Oh, wait, stop.
Where went the...
What?
Wait, no, go.
For odd reason, Sonic somehow brings the missile back to the ship to...
Okay, didn't Robotnik even try to make sure that missile was... Gah!
You now have 5 seconds to comply. 4, 3, 2, 1. I am now authorized to use deadly force.
Wait.
5. 5. How'd that be for a movie script?
All right. Thank God knows what. And.
5, as fast as you can. You can't. Fly as fast as you can! You can't catch me! I'm Sonic the Hedgehog!
Alright, that was perfect!
Suck it, indie fan. I'm just too confused as... Suck it, indie fan. I'm just... Suck it, indie fan. I'm just so confused as the wa... As to... Sorry.
That's right.
Suck it, indie fan. I'm just... Suck it, indie fan. I'm just so confused as to why the egg ship didn't blow up.
Right. Oh, fuck! Okay, that was perfect.
Alright, that situation's taken care of, but where did you afford that thing?
Okay, first off, he's not a thing. Wait, line. Yeah, first off, I didn't afford him. Okay, hold on. Yeah, that's right.
Offended face.
Alright. Okay, first off, I didn't afford him. I hired him. He's not a... Secondly... Damn it. Alright.
Okay, first off, I didn't afford him. Hired him.
Okay, now I remember. Alright, first off, I didn't afford him. I hired him. He's not a thing. Secondly, don't you ever refer to him as such. He's just as sentient as you and me. And thirdly, he's my bodyguard! So kindly check your bigotry at the door and show some respect.
So can you try that line again and go back to the offended face?
Alright. Alright,
good. Finally.
Okay.
Okay, I think that's good. So can we try one more take?
All right then.